Hi viewers, this is Selvin Kasperov and you're watching CNEWS. Today we have Dr. Saji Varghese from the Department of English. He's not only a professor, but also an innovator. Dr. Saji, a member of Innovation Center at Christ, is well known for his innovation. His latest innovation on biodegradable straws from coconut leaf has won second place among 143 entries from national level startup competition organized by IIT Delhi and Unnat Bharat Abhiyan on December 2nd, 2017. Let's welcome Dr. Saji. How are you, sir? How do you feel?
I'm very good. And I thank the Department of Media Studies for inviting me here.
So before we could get into the interview, sir, at a time when we are advancing in technology, be it medicine or fashion or anything else for the matter, don't you think that we are simultaneously going back to traditional ways of catering to human needs?
Yeah, actually, Kasparov, what the point I want to highlight is, even as the world is moving in technology, there's a great need for us to roll back to some of our ancient ways of doing things, because in this fast-paced world, we are trying to make things easier and convenient, but we have actually caused a lot of harm to the environment. It is where exactly where our traditional ways of doing things will actually be very valuable. And that's where this straw is also going to make a huge impact.
Thank you. So, sir, what is the recent innovation that you and your team are working on?
Actually, Innovation Center works on student ideas, and there are more than 12 different ideas that we are working on, right from something in the realm of space technology to something as grassroots as trying to build a multiple corn roaster for the roadside street vendor. So it's quite varied. So these are some of the very rudimentary things which can actually make a huge impact.
So what's the name of your project and could you elaborate us?
Yeah, straw that we are making from coconut leaf, that is something which we are very excited about, because globally we are actually suffering a lot of damage because of all the plastic straws that we are using. And if you know, more than 3.3 billion metric tons of plastic waste lies in our oceans. And I think some of you must have seen that video of the sea turtle, which got an 8-inch plastic straw stuck in its nostril, and it had to be taken out by a rescuer. So that's the kind of damage that we are going to do to the, we are doing to the environment. So this particular straw can make a huge impact. And the moment it struck me that this coconut leaf can work as a straw, we were super excited about it, and we did a lot of lab tests, and we saw that it just has all the right properties to become the most perfect alternative to the present plastic straw. So we can in fact eliminate the entire use of plastic straws altogether and have this biodegradable straw globally.
So the name that you have given to your straws, can
you... it's called the Blessing Palms, because we believe that it's going to be a blessing globally from the environmental aspect, and also it's going to be a blessing to the rural communities who can actually generate a lot of income for themselves. So it's a blessing for everyone.
Okay. Do you have your samples for the product?
I brought a few for you people. These are the straws which I just tried to build the other day. Now we have two kinds of straws here. One is one which we include the midrib in it. So this helps, for example, if you have a tetra pack like this, and if you see this plastic straw is stuck to this, we want all the multinational companies and even our Indian companies like Patanjali, Bijoy and companies like this which make tetra packs to start using our biodegradable straw, because with a midrib, it is good enough to puncture the seal and it can go in, and I think you can even taste it. I hope it works perfectly well. And I think this is, I think Tetra Pak juices are being sold in humongous millions of pieces every day. So if you can imagine these plastic straws getting into our oceans, which, and then for hundreds of years nothing will happen to it, whereas this biodegradable straw will be degradable in a month's time. So I think we should, I so much want that this should be propagated and we start bulk production of it. And this is the normal straw. I made this of different diameters. just to show that we can cater to, you know, customized requirements. The best part is, you know, those palm leaf is as long as you want it.
Yes.
And you can roll it into diameters of whatever you want. So this is if you are drinking juices like papaya or something which is more thick, you can have a straw with a bigger diameter. And if you're having something like this, you can have a straw which is of this diameter. So in every way, it works perfectly well for us, Kasparov.
Okay, thank you, sir. This, it's a nice innovation. So, sir, what drove you to do this innovation, this project?
Innovation is not something which has anything to do with the subject that you study. It's all about your personal, you know, craziness, you can call it. And you always want to find a solution for the next thing that is happening around.
Okay.
And I just thought biodegradable straw is something which we have to start working on. Yeah. And it just struck me.
So, I have an idea. But I don't know how to go about it, where to begin, whom to approach. So, could you tell us, like, how to go, how to start the program, how to do the initiative at least?
Kasparov, I would like to tell you that you are living in the best of the times. Back in my times, if I had a good idea, I would just have to kill it in my own mind. But you are living at a time when you can bring your ideas right in front of the world the very next day. As far as Christ University is concerned, we have an innovation center here where we are very open to student ideas. We bring it up and then we discuss it among our mentors.
Yeah, yeah.
And we, and not that we have all the expertise to help you outright, but we can always network you with the right people.
Okay.
So Christ University in itself is a very good place where you can come up with your innovative idea.
Yeah, it's a good thing that the college or the university comes up with an innovative idea to help and support students. So, sir, about the patent. So, how long does a patent go, and how to approach, like, to whom to go for, like, in order to apply a patent for a product?
Yeah, and there are two stages. For example, if you have an idea but you're not sure exactly how this idea is going to take shape, you can file what is called a provisional specification. And if you're sure, for example, something like straw, where the whole concept is completely well defined, you can go for a complete specification and get it published in the Patent Journal of India. So it gets, if you go for an early publication, it gets published in a month's time.
Okay.
So you have rights over it.
Okay.
Though granting of patent might require 3 years' time.
Mm-hmm.
But you have full rights over a patent which gets published.
Okay, that's good to hear, sir. Mm-hmm. And, so coming back to your project, sir, who are the beneficiaries of your project?
It's very evident that environment is going to be the biggest beneficiary.
That's good.
But more importantly, it's going to generate unimaginable rural income. And I just don't want them, I don't want we to be patronizing that we are going to generate rural income. In fact, I foresee this little straw as becoming the brand of India globally.
How does this innovation help students or community or general society, sir?
Yeah, so I'll start with the students. For example, now because the straw already got a visibility at IIT Delhi and Ministry of Human Resource has decided to take it up, our next step immediately is to involve, let's say, the students of the Engineering College at Kingiri to take care of the device that we need to build to increase the rate of production.
Okay.
So the students from Engineering College, and then we have students from the Department of Biology who are actually working on an analysis of the leaf itself.
Mm-hmm.
To see all the aspects. For example, if I dip it in this juice, after 2 hours, is there any significant change in the juice itself?
Okay.
So there are students from biology who are involved, and then there are students from BBA and MBA who are working on the business aspect of it. And there are a few students from BCom who are working on the cost and the financial aspects of it. So if you see this little innovation, can suddenly become a huge platform for students from diverse streams.
Okay.
To work on all the aspects so that it becomes a successful commercial product.
What do you see are the principal or major setbacks for your project, sir?
I wouldn't call it a setback, but there are challenges which we need to tackle.
Mm-hmm.
For example, if you ask me, what sounds very exciting is that just the state of Kerala requires 3.3 million straws per day. And the US consumes 500 million straws per day, 500 million. So that's a huge demand.
Okay.
So the challenge is how to meet these demands. So the moment you can have the capability to meet these demands, it's going to generate huge income for our country.
Mm-hmm.
But the challenge is how do you make those devices? So that's one challenge. If you ask who our competitors are, I wouldn't compete it with the plastic straw because they are banned. You should not even compare it with the plastic straws.
So if I want to be an innovator, so what are the key skills or the necessary attributes that I have to develop?
The very first thing I would say is you have to be crazy. You have to be mad about a few things. If you see, it cannot be straight-jacketed academic exercise that you want to be an innovator. You just have to be mad about it, and then you're getting up odd times in the night and you start your experiments. So there is that innate drive in you to create something new which doesn't exist in the world. So the whole excitement itself gives you all the necessary skills. And of course, after you do that, then you have to be more methodological and then have a more scientific approach. Okay. Once you have an epiphany moment. Second thing I want to talk about is don't try to work in isolation. If you want to be an innovator, if you want to be a scientist, always have the mindset of collaborating.
Okay.
We in India have a tendency to, to play the cards close to our chest, not reveal it to anyone. But the moment you talk about it to other people, more value gets added to this.
Okay.
So always be a collaborator and be mad about the thing you want to find out.
Well, we really appreciate you coming on the show. And we are sure that your blessing palms becomes a blessing to one and all. Thank you, Dr. Saji Varghese. This is Selvin Kasperov signing off.